Hey, good to have you join us on TLS again this evening. It's the Knowledge Show coming to you live from the studio of MITV here in Alausa, Ikeja. You can also get to watch us on channel 255 DSTV. That calls are already coming in. Good evening once again, Tai Akepelu is my name. Standing in for Lola Sanusi, who is unavoidably absent for the past few months now. She's somewhere in the United States. And with me on the program, we have a very wonderful guest, as we'll be dealing with another interesting topic today. But I have my co-anchors on TLS this evening. I have Kemi Stone. Kem, how are you?
Very well.
Happy Sunday.
Thank you.
And we also have Sheyi Oshinowo, the Balogun Armist. Good evening, Sheyi.
Good evening.
How are you?
Pretty good.
To see you again this Sunday.
You too. How was your weekend?
Fine, thank you. So this evening on TLS, we want to look at, maybe we should just put off the phone once it's time for us to allow you in. We'll let you know. Please do not call us now. On TLS this evening, we have the first woman cargo company in Lagos State who started her business since 1984, and she's known as Kekelodi. This evening we want to look at women in Nigeria's imports export business, and we have a woman, the first woman who started it. Who exactly am I talking about here? We have the presence of Princess Titi Layo Oshinowo on TLS this evening. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
You're looking very mwah.
Thank you.
I would say she looks like a bag of money.
Wow. You look like a bag of money.
Yes.
I think so.
Of course she is.
I'm loaded.
All right. Welcome on TLS.
Thank you for having me.
All right.
Export, I'm happy to be here.
Export business, ma'am. Mm-hmm. In the shop profile we have here, you started this business since 1984. How was it? How was export business then and now? What can you say?
By 1984, the business was so good and they were looking for the people to do the business. But we have few people in the business. Even men, we have few men in the business.
Had few men in the business.
Yes.
So how did you go into that business? Uh-huh. How did you come into it? How did you come about export business?
Okay. I was looking for a job. I went to Nigerian Airways Cargo Department. As I was sitting, then somebody came in as an allergy, was talking to the assistant cargo manager called Mr. Akin Yale, I don't know.
Don't worry, just go ahead.
Yes. So after the man left, I told the man that I knew this man. He said, you know him? Call him. I call him inside. And then he said, where do you know me from? I said, I knew you with my sister. That my sister is the mother to Jide Tinubu. Because we are first cousin.
All right.
So she said, what up of that her sister in the University of Lagos? That Titi Layo. I said, that's me. Because by then, life changes. When you are young, when you get into marriage, things will can fall apart, things can be good, things can be rough.
You never can tell.
You never can tell what is coming over you. But that's how the man said, okay, let's go. They engaged me into the business that very hour without writing any application.
Wow.
He introduced me to people there, the people I met in the office. And he said that immediately he took me to the tarmac. And that tarmac, that was the time this man, the first airline operator, left the airport. By then, Dr. Fani, Intercontinental, before Cabo and Okada. Okada came to meet me at the airport. When I started my cargo business. The man was telling me, this is where you'll be palletizing, this is where you'll be conveying your cargo into the aircraft, this and that. As if an angel is standing between me and him. And he came to state it that time.
And the rest is history.
My goodness.
Now, ever since you started being popular, how has it been? And how have you been able to meander your way in the midst of men, knowing full well that it's a man's business?
You've forgotten something, that what a man can do, a woman can do it better. Ah, do you know that?
The only woman in the midst of men.
Okay, let me tell you. The way I positioned myself by then, when I came into that, okay, and you know that, let me, I know you have only 30 minutes.
Yes, ma'am.
But I will cut it small.
Okay.
So that you can know, because what I'm going to say today is going to inspire so many ladies,
you
young
want
ladies.
To be inspired.
Yes, including yourself.
Yes, ma'am, I am
okay.
Already.
Okay, by then, as I said, we started the business. I couldn't even sit down in the office as a cashier. That's the only person they want. But I don't know. I just pushing myself. The other people, they were there, they can't do nothing. I will push myself. I'm be doing, weighing. I'm the one to weigh, I'm the one to sew, I'm the one to collate, I'm the one to do everything. Everybody will just sit down and be looking, and they are killing themselves, they don't know. Until when the company, they have license to operate, to convey passenger, because they are an airline. They have the first operation, that was 1983. They had their the operation, to hide the operation. They went, they came back, they made money, but there was a problem in between their board of directors. So within 3 months, the business collapsed. We can't get salary. As a hard-working person, I have to go back to Nigerian Airways. Please, I want to be collecting cargo because I need money to help my family. So they said, we know you are hard-working. Go and collect cargo. That's how I started. There was a dramatic change. The people are coming highway by way to bring business to me. Then all of a sudden, I get two containers, seaport container. I place it down along the road. By then, I don't have office. But immediately, I have to register my business with the government of Nigeria. After that, I have an accountant, I do everything I'm supposed to do by then, before going to Abuja. Then, there was no Abuja by then. I do everything, okay. Now I know that I go to the Export Promotion Council, I get all papers that I need to get.
You did all your due diligence.
That's right.
To start importing.
So that nobody can harass me. If you are a police officer, you are a custom officer, you challenge me, you delay me. I know you delay me for a certain time, but no reason. They want to do their job. That's why government employed them to be there to see what is going out of the country. Sometimes some people, my colleagues, the men that they see that I'm doing competition with them, some of them and the lady that joined me after that too, they will go and instigate custom against me. That was Ms. Obokun, Bola Obokun Dare, by then. I'm her mentor, because she came to meet me after 3 months I started the business. Aburo, I can hear that you are here. How do you do this? And I show her the way. Then after her, another Hausa lady joined us again. They call her company Agila. Another man too, they come and say, if a woman can do this, what are we waiting for? They started. Then after many years, then that's how you started seeing some small girls, they come up to be doing touting along the road.
Okay.
And some boys too. But that one, when they see some people, they will join the company to work with them. After some times, they go and start their own. But none of my workers fall out. No. They don't, because I satisfy them. And I do a role of a mother to them. And then this business, you can't do it alone.
Now you cannot do it alone. Mm-hmm. That's another angle to it. Now then let's look at the challenges. The challenges of this business. Mm-hmm. Being a mother, a wife, a CEO, how were you able to overcome, to surmount these challenges?
First thing first, charity begins at home. Play a role of a good woman in your house. Let your husband put trust in you as a married woman.
Okay.
Once your husband can trust you, the children too can trust you. You have a little change, you bring it back home. Your children, they eat good. And again, they themselves, there was a dramatic change in the life of my children. because we started from a small house, a small room, room face to face. Then after the money was coming, I see that there will be a jealousy. Then I call my husband. We have to understand each other now. I'm not a boss. You are the boss of the house. And she see that I submitted myself to him. Beside what I say, I did at Kingsway Road 19, Kingsway number 19, Kingsway Road, in 52 years ago. When I say I do for my husband. He trusts me. He used to tell his colleagues at his office that when you go so hour, you will meet my wife doing this. And when they come, they meet me like that. So that's one, I don't have challenges in my husband now.
Okay.
And then I take all it takes. The money, I don't eat it alone. I bring into the house. I make sure that we left the house of Face Me, I Face You. We went to rent a house, one at Onigbom border side of Maryland. Later, we came to F. Governor Shoba's house. At Mende, Maryland. The color of his house is what I'm using in any of my houses today. Yes, because I love the building. I was using a occupying one. Mrs. Abiola was using one. And then Lai Muhammad was using one. The other man was using another side. So we don't see each other. But everybody, we don't have any conflict with anybody.
Now, the challenges of import and export business.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes government policy could change.
Yes.
The people you're working with.
A lot. Mm-hmm.
So I want us to look at it because I know after today's program, mm-hmm. Most of us, or every one of us on this set, will be inspired and want to
of course, yes.
export and yes. import mm-hmm. business.
And I'm ready to help anybody that is ready.
Now, Ma, I want us to talk about the challenges.
The challenges.
Now, away from your matrimonial home, yes, mm-hmm. you've been able to sell that.
Yes.
Now, the challenges in that business.
In that business.
Being the only woman in
let me field. Tell you something. Okay. They call me Margaret Tasha. This is Kekelodi you are looking. The Kekelodi you know before. Action woman at the airport. I don't have any man friend among them. They like to love me, but I love my husband. I don't do that. If on airlines, they try to make friends with me, no. Because by making friends, that's part of challenges.
Oh.
Because when you
click your...
As a woman.
And as a fine woman.
They like, and I'm very portable. I'm not as big like this. But they now make me
you
to
are
do
still
like
fine.
This. Thank you. Thanks for the compliment. You know what? By then, those men, once you single yourself, you face your business. The government can change. Government always changing by then. They will, because of the people among us that they don't even register their business with government, they now be coming in, then the custom too, they are giving them hard time in which that they can't be able to get good report to back to their offices. So therefore, they impose power that anybody doesn't have this, you have to do this, this, that. The paper we are using by then was changing. You have to get this. Many law enforcement agencies came into the business. But once you have your documents, you don't need to bribe anybody. They are not ready to get your bribe because they are there to do their legitimate business, to get good report to the government, back to them. Nobody wants to lose their job. Just do whatever you know is good for you to do to smoothen your business and to satisfy your customers that you are conveying cargo for.
For how long have you been in this business, man?
I work in this for my own. I
serve as the CEO of Kekelodi.
Yes, ma'am. I serve worldwide in Nigeria because not only Nigeria.
Okay.
Because all the customers that are coming to me, they are foreign people coming from
okay.
highway countries. So those people, when they come, we do the business, they go on their way. I lost something there. Come back with your question again, please.
Wow. Mommy, before we go back to this question,
mm-hmm. if you have another question,
we
let's
need
go.
To go mm-hmm. on a short break.
That's okay.
Because we have millions of people on the set. They have questions to okay. ask you.
Okay.
Well, it's the Lola Show. We told you when this program was about to start that time we have so much for you based on our talking. And as you can see, my co-anchors are not talking. Sheyi and Kemi.
We have
wow. We are inspired. I'm sure you are too. When we return, we'll take it up from there. Stay with us.
Talk about politics and sports, education and all information. Entertainment and fashion and business, you know we got it all. Too many goodies in the goodie bag. Too many things to talk about. I show. In case you don't know, we all around the globe. Welcome to the show.
This is
Hi. Hi guys.
Hi there.
Hello. I'm Miss Tourism Nigeria 2021.
My name is Victoria Omozele Igberaise, Miss Glam Nigeria.
My name is Yvonne, Miss Tourism Nigeria model.
I'm Stella DK, Miss Environmental Nigeria 2021. Keep watching.
Keep watching.
Keep watching.
The Lola Show.
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 Don't go nowhere.
The Lola Show, and we have the first woman, you know, to run the cargo company in Nigeria, Mrs. Titilayo Aino Kekelodi. So now I would like to ask you something, ma'am. Mm-hmm. You know, we're talking about the challenges before we went on
break. I'm break, shut
because by. You know, being the only women, you know, in that business, you know, you have a lot of men, you know, who want to bring you down, who want to throw passes at you, being the only woman. How were you able, you know, to overcome?
We're still on the challenges.
Yes.
And again, let me chip in this.
Okay.
What was it you were exporting?
Okay.
And importing as at that time?
Okay. These people from West Africa and South Africa, people, they come to Nigeria because Nigerian border was open to them to come and buy and be sold. When they come here, they bought all what we have here and go, it's a gold to their country. Nigeria is a blessed country. I wish God could open eyes of everybody to see what they are having here. Funny people are coming here to take all the glory to out of the country. They come here, they buy petty things. Maybe it could be like something they so good here, or some wristwatch, some fake something they do, other small something they do, and this plastic pure water, they can buy some of them, and then the machine, they go and be doing it over there. They will buy it plenty. They buy many things in Lagos here. They buy everything here and go and sell in their country. And then they can't just go like that because they have only maybe 20 kilos or 50 kilos, 50 pounds to convey out of the country with their ticket. Mm. So they have to go through cargo. And when they come to cargo, by then we weigh it because as a licensed custom agent and also affiliation, because I'm using international license too, from Geneva. My license is from Geneva that I use with my cargo business. Then when we collect cargo, we go to the airline. The airline, as I'm their agent, they give me their airway bills. When I weigh their cargo, they sit down in their office, I'm working for them. When I weigh their cargo, then I charge the customer. This is what is in the tariff. This is what is in the tariff. And then they pay the money. Mean that I'm working for you, I don't work for nothing.
All right, ma'am. I have to pay for my something. Like you said, you know, you've worked with the white people
and the, you know, black people here.
When they come into Nigeria, you know, to import things like the African
to export
African stuff, you know, they have a lot of things in Nigeria.
Antiquities, yes.
Maybe precious stones, you know,
yes,
all those gems.
I have license for that one too.
Oh, okay.
I get all my license because once I see that the government impose power that we have to have this, we have to have that, and you have to obey the law. I obey the law. I have all it takes to convey anything I want to convey
now,
out of the country.
Import and export business is not a child's play.
It's not. It's not. Ah.
It's capital intensive.
I'm telling you.
Now, who was funding you? And as at that time, and we know that there was no so much corruption as at the time you started this business. Who was bankrolling you, ma?
The kishiti, why you are not in bank? You understand? Corruption started from the one. Genesis of this world. From the Bible, from the Quran.
Okay.
So corruption started
as
before
we, there.
Of that, and it will be like that.
Funding you, was it your husband or you still you were able to gather money?
I told you what that what cargo is. I'm an agent to the airline, official.
Okay.
Then when I work for you, you have to pay me my money. In, I have intensive from them.
So the
I have commission. Commission from the airline. And then the you that I'm conveying your cargo to use all my license to cover you up, to put you under my umbrella.
Okay.
You have to
pay for it.
You have to pay for it. That money, I use it to pay my office because by then we are using outside. Later, I was using former Nigerian Airways Post Office at Old Domestic and found Nigerian Airport Authority. Call on reputable cargo consolidator that we are going to build a place for you guys. Then you have to pay for it, in which I was occupying 72 square meters at Naco Shed, former cargo shed. And me and Oboku, we are sharing the whole building, the long building.
Now, cargo business, ma.
Yes.
As capital intensive as it is.
You use your sense to get your money. You don't need to have a dime before you start cargo.
I'm going to ask you.
Yes, ask me a question.
Now, how can women make money from this tough business that we're talking about?
Okay. Now,
how profitable is this business?
It's just like when you put a slab of ice block and put it in a drum of warm water. You know it's cold, then you tie it, this pure water you are selling. Maybe you buy the block like 1 naira, I don't know. When you buy like 1 naira, then you put it inside the bucket of water and then you started putting them inside the nylon bag. Then that plastic bag, you sell it maybe like maybe 50 kobo, maybe 1 naira. You see how many you are going to get from that bucket. That's how it is.
It's a lucrative and profitable business.
It's very mean for me. You have nothing to lose. You have nothing to lose. When I started, I don't have a dime.
When you export, what do you import?
When I was exporting my own, I started exporting Champion Malta.
Mommy, and what do you bring in? I don't want us to mention products.
Okay, not even only that one. I'm exporting many things that under my license can cover, that government was approved for it. Then I was, because there are many inspectors that came to this country, government of Nigeria, they allow investor to come here, in which I fortunate to see one man, Mr. Shen, in Taipei, Taiwan, and we are business partner. I started conveying and it's bringing back to me these are shopping lights.
Mommy, you've been in this business for the past how many years? 28,
20, 30, 35? I served worldwide 20 good years at the airport. And I'm also a licensed custom agent.
Okay.
And in which this is one of my merit award.
Okay.
You can show it to people I'm lying.
Okay.
Yeah, this is it.
Association of Nigerian Licensed Customs Agents Merit Award presented to Mrs. Titi Lion Oshinowon.
That's right.
This was presented in year 2004.
Yes.
This particular one. Yes.
Recognition.
Recognition.
For my recognition of hard work.
Yes.
And the other one you see there, this one, because you asked me one question.
Yes.
That why can't I open that school?
We have it on the screen already.
Aha. So that one is from School of Aviation. Because anytime any student go to that school, the director always send them to my company. And I always taking them. Once I accommodate them, they will blend with us.
Okay.
Anyone that is lazy, I push them out.
No.
And those that I can do the job, yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to bring you back now.
Okay, bring me back. I'm ready.
People know Kekelodi.
Of course, yes.
From From what we have on the screen on this phone box, mm-hmm. we have about 173 callers missed calls.
You see that?
We've not opened the lines.
We'll try to open the line.
But please, the people at the MCR should please place the number on the TV screen so that we can engage more calls. Now, as Kekelodi International,
mm-hmm.
why did you not, or do you have any school, aviation school established in this name that the younger generation can go to learn from?
No, because we have one or two people having the school already. And the one I have in my basket is enough for me to carry. Shoulder is full. I can't. I don't want to kill myself because the challenges for the family, you know, I can't put all my life in my business and forget my husband.
Okay.
Then I don't want to lose my home.
Sure.
So that's why I let that one go.
Okay, so you didn't think in the line of establishing a school?
I thought about it, but I don't want to be inside.
All right.
Because it would be too much on my shoulder to carry.
Now,
you don't want to call business. Not those people you are seeing jumping. You have to do statistics of the business before you go too much deep into it. When I studied it, then I know that I can go further, in which I was going further. Okay. All this airline, foreign airline, they married to my business. KLM did my first bus to use in this country.
Okay.
KLM give it to me free of charge.
We have people that will
Lufthansa, ask. KLM, and Air France, and so on.
Hello,
yes,
people
ma'am.
People are here, they want to ask questions.
Okay,
good
ma'am.
Evening. Good evening, sir. What's your name?
Obinna.
I can hear myself talk. Please move away from your TV set. Yeah, Obinna, go ahead. He's trying to reduce the volume and we love him.
Another person
is there.
Mm-hmm.
Good evening.
Good evening,
sir. What's your name? Where you calling from? Adiolu from Lagos, Alimosho. Good to have you join us on TLS. What's your contribution or question for our guest? Oh no.
Okay. Let me quickly ask mom.
Okay.
You know, looking at mom, like how old will you tell people, okay, how old am I? Can you first tell them your age? And again, I'm so inspired by you, like your age, you're still very
The age thing.
She's still very, very energetic and all that.
Age,
your age now and the...
I'm 75 years old.
By the grace of God.
Good evening.
And I'm still working.
Good evening, ma'am.
Ah.
Hello, okay. Good evening.
Oops.
Good evening. Yes. Please, what is your name, sir?
And where is he calling from?
You're calling from Edo State. What's your name again, sir? Okay, Prince Jackson or DRC. She's here.
Hi.
She's here.
Hi, guys.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You so much. God bless you.
Oh no.
Thank you. God bless you and bless your family.
Thank you. Oh
thank
my.
You.
Oh my.
I'm really inspired by her energy. I swear to God. And mommy, I would like you to, you know, advise
you
all the youth,
let me tell
all
you.
The young people before
let me tell you. Let me tell you. I know.
Before
as I'm
go.
Talking to you
we
now,
to
as I got, I went, I sat here 20 good years. Mm. I'm in US now.
Mommy will
and
have
I,
you again. Mommy will
before she leaves, she needs to, you know, probably advise the youth.
Short in 1 second.
Oh my God.
I'm still working three jobs a day. In America.
Wow. Thank you very much, Mommy.
24/7.
Thank you very much. People want to ask questions, but we just need to go.
And I'm ready. I'm
now.
Ready to train anybody that is ready
yeah.
to do the business and put them through.
Thank
without
you.
Without taking a dime.
Thank you.